My name is Barry Land. I own and operate Soulful Garage Creations out of my house and garage. And I make a little bit of everything. Mid-30s.
Really?
Yeah, kind of. I mean, I've always done something artistic. However, I sort of sat on it for years and was distracted by just life and other things. And then I would say, yeah, within the last handful of years, I really started rolling. I didn't start doing any weld sculpture, metal sculpture, until 2013, 14, somewhere in there. I've always drawn, I've always written. I dabbled with, you know, I used to publish fanzines and stuff like that. I've always had some kind of creative outlet, but this kind of stuff I haven't really started until the last couple of years, really. Skateboarding's probably to blame for most what I do now as an adult. I mean, that introduced me to music, art, or, you know, the style of art. Robert Williams and you know, Big Daddy Roth even, and things like that, through skateboarding, because those guys were all ripping off that kind of artwork anyway for skateboard graphics and stuff. So I was turned onto it at like 10 years old, you know, when I got my first Thrasher magazine, and from there, you know, that's what I'm into. I mean, you can probably tell by looking around the house. In college, I went to school for graphic arts and broadcasting and things like that, and so I mean, even to this day, I use stuff that I learned in college, because it was the mid-90s and we were still doing stuff old school, cut and paste, which is kind of what I do in here, you know, and with paint and airbrushes and things like that. So I definitely still use those things that I've learned and kind of just I'm sort of self-taught. I mean, it's like, well, I'm going to try it. I think I sat on it for years because I didn't quite know what I was doing, and I thought about it. I spent 5 years hoarding metal from bike parts and stuff from working on motorcycles, and then when my friends helped me move and stuff, they'd be like, what the hell are we moving all this stuff for? Well, and then, you know, finally I started making stuff out of it, you know. But I started doing weld art, sculpture and stuff, and making just out of scrap metal. I mean, I'm a route driver for the Columbia Street Roastery here in town, and so if I see, well, not so much anymore, but if I used to see something laying on the side of the road, a muffler or whatever, I'd pick it up, you know, bring it home, and it'd set. Usually there's always something stewing, you know, in my head, so, you know, I might see something and be like, oh, that's going to be a fill in the blank, and then, you know, it might sit for a month, it might sit for a day, it might sit for a couple of years. Well, the painting I just started doing probably in 2015, 16, and then since then I've started just kind of going, well, why not? And just doing whatever strikes my fancy. I think really the weld sculpture has led to, I'm not a great painter by any means, but it's doing the three-dimensional stuff has led me to being able to see things differently, if that makes sense. It's kind of like, the generic answer is, what's your favorite piece? Well, the last one I did, you know, that kind of thing. But yeah, I typically have an idea that I'll nurture some way or another, and I'll think about it, like, you know, throughout the work day at my day job or something, and then I can come home and when I have the time and kind of put it to, you know, paper or metal or whatever. I think there's a piece in the garage that's kind of like an old race car, but it's kind of got a space age vibe, at least to me, to it, or it will when it's done. And it was, I don't even know what the thing is, it looks like some kind of dispenser, but originally I saw it at the Idea Store in Urbana, and it kind of looked like a head, and it almost kind of looked like Finn off of Finn and Jake, like it had that kind of, you know, Adventure Time, where it had that kind of look to it, and I'm like, that could be a cool robot, spaceman, I don't know. But as it sat around, I had that piece for a couple years, until earlier this year, back in winter of last year, I guess, and I you know, was like, well, you know, what if I turn it this way? And then it looked like a cockpit kind of, or, you know, whatever for a race car, you know? So that's what it became. And then, you know, we got tricycle parts laying around. When you see the garage, you'll kind of get an idea. There's boxes of stuff everywhere, and it's like, And so, you know, I just kind of, basically to answer your question better, I think, yes, I either have an idea and I think it to death until I put it on paper, or an object strikes me and he's like, that looks like, and then it eventually becomes that. Pretty much just start doing it. I've got a sketchbook sitting right next to you there, and it's like I rarely use them. Sometimes I'll especially on the things that aren't canvas, like wood or whatever I'm painting on, sometimes I'll do a rough sketch, and then I'll use some carbon transfer paper, and then I'll go over that to put the image on the thing so I'm not freehanded. Sometimes I freehand it though. Sometimes I'll just get a pencil and just sketch it out. So it's kind of organic. I guess it's organic, just how it comes together. I mean, usually it is just jump in and do it. You know what I mean? Like, I got an idea. I mean, I'll look up, like if I'm going to do like a Frankenstein or something. I mean, I'll look up, some source material, but I don't blatantly rip it off. I just kind of, okay, I need to put the, it's more about proportions and things, And like when I'm doing the weld art stuff, I mean, it's the same thing. I literally stand in whatever position I'm trying to put the guy in and be like, okay, this needs to go like that, and I mean, it's a whole process. I'm not a very good businessman, I don't feel. So like I'm constantly creating and constantly, like I said, got some kind of creative outlet going on. Would I love to do this for a job? Of course I would, but then there's a lot of other things that go into that factor, and like a regular paycheck and insurance and things of that nature. So I do work a day job. I do this in my free time. And, I think I started strong, in the first couple of years. And I don't think I'm slower. I used to make stuff like all the time, like boom, 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 stuff would be turning out. And now I'm always working on something, but I'm working on multiple things. So I'm not like creating something every day or two. You know what I mean? It's like always in the works kind of. Well, I'm very fortunate that people like to buy my stuff, I guess. I think that, I don't know, maybe it's, I've had like people trying to figure out what parts are in there. People trying, they're like, whoa, you give it like character. Like it has, I don't know. I guess I have an ability to animate inanimate objects, if that makes sense, I don't think that's how it was in the beginning, although maybe it was. It was just a little simpler, a simpler whatever, like execution of the idea. But like I made some really detailed motorcycles and stuff, and little motorcycle sculptures and whatnot, and I realized that I could take a triangle and two circles and I'm like, oh, it's a motorcycle, and then you look at it a year later and you go, oh, I'm glad they bought it, but I'm gonna add pipes and levers and it's all like the cliche goes, right? It's all the little details that sort of lend to the big picture. I recently did I painted the back of a ukulele for a friend for his granddaughter, and he wanted a lion's head, and I think he thought that he was going to get just like a stencil like lion head on there, which was originally what I was going to do. And then once I got here, I was like, dude, is it cool if I just go ahead? And he's like, yeah, just run with it, And I did, and you can tell I painted it. It looks like this other stuff I did, but it's lion's head, and that's just layers and layers and layers. And I'm sure to some people, they look at it and they're like, it's cartoon, whatever, But, there's a lot that goes into that stuff. Not just for me, but for anybody that makes something,